Welcome to our channel, Basic Physics. Today I will discuss about carrier concentration in an intrinsic semiconductor. So, we all know that an intrinsic semiconductor has same amount of electrons and holes.
Okay.
So, now we apply empty statistics. If we apply empty statistics, then we can write the number of carriers in a band at finite temperature, which will be given written in equal to integration n c e function of energy band. Fe, which is also a function of energy, and D, where this NCE equal to gamma of E minus EC. EC means energy at conduction value to the half, where gamma was equal to 4 pi by h cube 2 me star 3/2, where me star is the effective mass of electron and h equal to Planck constant, as we all know. And here this small function f is a Fermi Dirac function, because as we for electrons, here we apply Fermi Dirac statistics. Okay. So from this equation, we can also write the concentration of electron in conduction band. Concentration of electron in conduction band, which will be N equal to here in conduction band, this limit will be EC to infinity NC E FE E into D. Okay, now we know that this Fermi Dirac function actually equal to 1 by 1 plus e to the power e minus e f by kt, where k is Boltzmann constant and t is absolute temperature. Okay, now if for e much or even at greater than equal ec, we can write E minus EF, which will be much greater than KT. Okay. So, from this, we can write FEE equal to, this value will be larger. Okay. So, we can neglect this plus one term. Okay. So it will be to the power EF minus EF will be plus EF. If we transfer this E value from denominator to numerator, E divided by KT. Okay. So now put this value of FE here. So N will be EC to infinity. Now NC is given as gamma, this gamma E minus EC to the power half into E to the power EF minus E by KT into D. Okay. Now, we have to calculate this equation. Okay. Then, we assume, let assume what x equal to, x is a function, what e minus ec by kt. Okay, so from here we can write e minus ec equal to x kt. Okay. And also dE equal to kt times of tx. Okay, so we can write n equal to integration ec to infinity gamma times of x to the power half kt to the power half e to the power ef minus bc minus x kt all divided by kt into kt into dx. Now we have to change the limit also. Okay, so we know that this, okay, if e equal to ec then it will be 0, then x will be 0 to e is infinity, then x will be also infinity, so limit will be 0 to infinity. Okay, now next step we can write gamma and e to the power ef minus ec by kt, which is not a function of x. Okay, and it will be treated as a constant. Okay, so that's why we remove this term from the integration and kt to the power 3 by 2 integration 0 to infinity x to the power half e to the power minus x into dx. Now if we remember the gamma function, then we will, this value is basically gamma function, so it is basically what, it is basically gamma 3 by 2. Okay, so we know that gamma n plus 1 equal to n gamma n, so we can write it will be half gamma half, and we also know that the value of gamma half equal to root 5 by 2. Okay, so from this we can write this value. Now put the value of gamma also here, gamma also, this small gamma also. Okay, so if we put the value of small gamma, which is 4 pi by h cube 2 m e star to the power 3 by 2 into kt to the power 3 by 2 into pi by 2 into e to the power ef minus ec by kt. Okay, so we can write this value is also 2, this h cube will be inside, then it will be 2 pi m star into kt divided by h square of 3 by 2 into the fun ef minus ec by kt. Okay, so this value of n equal to, so from this we can also write it is equal to nc times of e to the power ef minus ec by kt. So where nc equal to 2 pi m star kt by h square to the power 3 by 2. Okay, so this equation, basically this equation gives us the number of electrons present in the conduction band of an intrinsic semiconductor. Okay, so this is the equation. Okay, the number of electrons in conduction band. Now, in similar approach, we can also calculate the number of holes in valence band. Okay, so from this, we can also write that P, the number of hole, equal to here limit will be minus infinity to EV. Okay, and here in V times of E, function of H for hole, okay, D. Now, here, well, in V equal to, which is also gamma, now we can write V minus E to the power half, okay, and gamma equal to 2, sorry, that gamma 4 pi by h cube 2 m h star to the power 3 by 2. Okay. And this f h function of e is also a parameter function for hole. Okay. So, in a semiconductor, intrinsic semiconductor, the number of holes and number of electron. So from this function, this function will be sum of this function P will be 1. So from this we can write F H E equal to 1 minus F E D. Okay. So from this we can also write that e to the power e minus ef by kt divided by 1 plus e to the power e minus ef by kt. Now, if ef minus e much greater than kt, which means this value will be negative, much negative, e to the power minus some huge value, so it will be 0, then it will be 1, the up f h e will be e to the power e minus e f by kt. Okay, so from this we can write the value of P, where we get the this value P is P equal to will be P equal to integration from minus infinity to EV gamma into EV minus E, put the value of NV, okay, and E to the power E minus EF by KT into D. Now here also let us assume EV minus E by KT equal to Y. Okay. Then E equal to EV minus Y KT. Okay. Then DE equal to minus KT times of DE. Y. Okay. So from this we can also write P equal to now for minus infinity, if we put minus infinity of hello E, then Y will be also plus infinity. Okay. Y will be plus infinity. So it will be infinity. And this value will be, if we put the value E equal to V, then Y will be 0, then it will be 0. Okay, so limit will be changed. And it will be gamma, EV minus E means Y KT. So Y KT to the power half, and E to the power EV minus EF minus YKT, this is Y, KT, YKT into D, sorry. Now we have to change DU also, so then it will be minus KT into DY. Okay. So from this, we can write comma e to the power EV minus EF by KT, okay, and KT to the power 3 by 2, and this negative sign will change the limit. Infinity to 0 will be 0 to infinity, okay, 0 to infinity. So it will be y to the power of e to the power minus y and dy, and this is also a gamma function which is equal to, basically which is equal to gamma 3 by 2, and this value will be root 5 by 2. Okay, put this value also. So we put the value of gamma also. So from this we can write also 2 into 2 mh star into pi into kt by h square to the power 3 by 2 e to the power v minus tf by kt. Okay. So from this we can also write p equal to nv times of e to the power v minus f by kt. Okay. So this is equation number 2. So from this equation denotes that the number of holes present in the valence band of an intrinsic semiconductor. Okay. Now, if M E star means effective mass of electron equal to effective mass of hole. Okay. And for an intrinsic semiconductor, we know that N equal to P. So if we put this value, then it will be NC into the value e to the power EF minus EC by KT equal to NV times of e to the power EV minus EF by KT. So from this, now the value of NC is, the value of NC is this one, and the value of NV is, will be key, will be 2 ME star pi KT h square to the power 3 by 2 into 2, means both same. Here MH R, and in the value of NC, M E star. Okay. So here is the difference now. N E, M E star and MH star both are equal. Then we can also write NC equal to NV. Okay. Both are same. Then we can write e to the power EF minus EC by KT equal to e to the power EV minus EF by KT. So from this we can also write EF minus EC equal to EV minus EF. So from this we can also write 2 into EF equal to EC plus EV. So from this we can also write EF, the Fermi energy, equal to HC EC plus EV by 2. So Fermi energy lies between conduction and valence band at middle. Okay. Middle. And if M star not equal to MH star, if it is not equal, but for an intrinsic semiconductor, N equal to P. Okay. So from this we can also write NC into e to the power EF minus EC by KT equal to NV e to the power EV minus EF by KT. Okay. So from this we can also write NC by NV, which is equal to basically ME star by MH star to the power 3 by 2 equal to E to the power EV minus EF minus EF plus EC by KT. So if we take logarithm in both sides, then it will be 3 by 2 ln ME star by MH star equal to EV plus EC by KT minus 2 EF by KT. Okay. So from this we can also write EF, the value of EF will be EV plus EC by 2 minus 3 by 4 KT times of ln ME star by MH star. Okay. So here we find the value of Fermi energy. Okay. So if you like our videos, please like, share with your friends and subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching.